Vascular Endothelial Growth Factor, VEGF, is, as its name suggests, a factor that promotes the growth and proliferation of blood vessel cells. When these cells receive it, they proliferate and extend like budding branches.
I want to grow bigger. I need more nutrients. I need oxygen. All right, let's pull blood vessels towards me.
Cells release vascular endothelial growth factor, blood vessel cells eat and, extending blood vessels towards the cells that provided the food.
Haha, here come the blood vessels. With this, I can proliferate even more.
Let's expand the blood vessels. Vascular endothelial growth factor binds to vascular endothelial growth factor receptor, which is located on the surface of endothelial cells within blood vessels. When the receptor receives, it becomes activated and helps blood vessel cells grow and perform DNA synthesis. Vascular endothelial growth factor is significantly increased in many types of cancer cells.
Cancer cells release vascular endothelial growth factor. What happens next?
It helps grow blood vessels that give nutrients and oxygen to the cancer cells.
Cancer cells that receive nutrients and oxygen from the blood can proliferate even more.
Angiogenesis inhibitors come in two main types. The first type is called monoclonal antibodies, and the second type is called small molecule inhibitors.
What is the mechanism of action?
Bevacizumab is a monoclonal antibody that works by blocking vascular endothelial growth factor.
Bevacizumab works by blocking vascular endothelial growth factor.
Ramucirumab works by blocking vascular endothelial growth factor receptor A2.
Ramucirumab works by blocking vascular endothelial growth factor receptor 2.
This receptor is found in endothelial cells and some vascular tumors, but there are also many reports showing that it's found in certain cancer cells. Bevacizumab targets VEGF, while ramucirumab targets VEGF receptor. Make sure not to mix them up.
On the other hand, what do these small molecules target?
These small molecules target tyrosine kinases.
Tyrosine kinases?
Let's start from the beginning as a review and to make sure everything is clear. When vascular endothelial growth factor binds to their extracellular domain of vascular endothelial growth factor receptors, they trigger receptor dimerization, which then activates receptor tyrosine kinases using ATP. Tyrosine kinase inhibitors bind and block downstream signal transduction.
Tyrosine kinases may be too active or found at high levels in some types of cancer cells, and blocking them may help keep cancer cells from growing.
The suffix NIB indicates a small molecule inhibitor of kinase enzymes.
These tyrosine kinase inhibitors have some distinctive features, right?
Yes, you're always sharp. Now, it's a bit tricky, but I'll add a little more explanation here. In the previous videos about EGFR inhibitors and HER2 inhibitors, I explained that tyrosine kinase inhibitors specifically block the tyrosine kinases attached to EGFR, and specifically block the tyrosine kinases attached to HER2. In short, even if you encounter a tyrosine kinase inhibitor, it means that it cannot inhibit tyrosine kinases attached to receptors other than EGFR. However, these tyrosine kinase inhibitors can also inhibit tyrosine kinases attached to different receptors, such as VEGFR1, PDGER, and other types of receptors, not just VEGF receptor 2. These kinds of drugs are called multi-targeted tyrosine kinase inhibitors. In addition, sorafenib can inhibit not only tyrosine kinases, but also serine-threonine kinases. In short, this is why these tyrosine kinase inhibitors are widely used in many treatments, right?
Here is the final question. What is an adverse effect of angiogenesis inhibitors?
Angiogenesis inhibitors prevent new blood vessel formation, as the name suggests. This can lead to impaired blood vessel repair, making bleeding more likely. Additionally, blood clot formation can occur more easily. There are also reports of high blood pressure.
Why does that cause high blood pressure?
It's suggested that this might be due to damage to endothelial cells, which affects their ability to produce enough NO, nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a substance that helps dilate blood vessels. So when angiogenesis inhibitors block the function of endothelial cells, the production of nitric oxide decreases, and blood vessels can't dilate properly and may even constrict, leading to increased blood pressure.
Thank you for watching.